Hi and welcome to this video. My name is Ihana and today I'm going to be opening up some of these pins. They are gouache colors from Arteza. This is not a sponsored video. It is just me who bought these for my artist boyfriend and I wanted to try them as well. So he has already made his own palette in ice cubes, but there are 60 colors in this big box. So there are several he hasn't even tried yet, and I have a couple of other favorites, and there are also metallics in the set. So I thought we'd just take a look at those today, so come along. Well, I said we'd open this, but this box is actually already empty because we took them out. Really like how colorful this is, and I'm just gonna set this to the side. I have a pad of paper that I thought I could do some swatching on along with you. So this is definitely not a review, since I have no idea if I'll like these colors. But this is how they come. And like I said, 60, you definitely do not need 60 colors in gouache. You can make your own hues and tints if you have a white and black, but it's really fun to see what they offer. So what I want to do is just try a few of these. I definitely want to try Pearl Bubblegum. It just has two pinks, and pink is my favorite color. Let me see. Yeah, so this is one that looks really good. It's called Peach Red. So I like it on the tube. We'll see if I like it swatched out. And then this one. So, I mean, it has a lot of browns. I would just need one. And a lot of blues and purples. Greens and orange. Yes, actually loads of green. So, oh, this looks good. Lime green, sage green, latte brown. Well, this is going to be hard. I was thinking just a quick video, but 60 colors we're not going to swatch. Definitely not. And in this video, I also wanted to show you two of my small palettes. I made these 2 years ago now, and I still haven't filled them. I took like a year of ceramics, and I made lots of flower pots and things like that. And I also did some smaller things like these two. And let me show you my little figurines that is here in the windowsill, just next to my desk. These guys I created, which I adore these. They're friends, so. And this one is little friend who's lying down. They're really cute, and I definitely love them. I made so much. I really should make a video showing some of my ceramic pieces and some of the process. I think I have those clips saved. So, like, in my house, it's everywhere. So, if you want to see a video of some quick clips of processes and me talking about the pieces I made in that class and a little bit about my experience with clay. Definitely not an expert on that either, but really enjoyed it, and I really want to have these on my desk filled with paint. So that's what we're doing. Put them to the side. Let's see, what should we start with? Yeah, we're just gonna start with the pinks because I'm most curious about those. So I have some water. I have a big paintbrush and I'm just gonna be swatcherooing. And hopefully it will help you if you're looking for gouache. I never paint with gouache. I'm a watercolor or acrylics kind of girl. But a gouache can behave kind of similar to both of those mediums. Like if you do it straight from the tube like that, it emulates acrylic. And if you use some water, it looks a little bit more like watercolors. So, oh, this is called pearl bubblegum pink. So it is pearlescent. It's a little bit of a shimmer into it and I really like it. Should we do one of these with mostly pinks maybe? Or metallics? I think metallics. This one has a bit of speckled paint on top of the glaze. So it has another kind of look than the white one. But I really like both. So fun to make too. I think I'll do this one for metallics. So hopefully we can open this in the future. This usually clog up. I don't know about this brand, but little tubes like this has a tendency to clog up and be impossible to open second time. But like I almost filled this entire little scoop of paint, but it's still a lot. So at least 3 or 4 of these you could fill with one tube, and that is plenty of paint, I'm sure. And in case you're new to gouache, the way you use these is that you can either just pour up a little bit and use them directly when they are wet still from the tube, or you can fill something like this ice cube tray and then you spritz it with water and re-wet them, and then they work like watercolor pans so that you can paint with them. And that is how gouache works, actually. Always. So even when this has dried, you can go in and add water and totally destroy a painting that you've done. Watercolors are not like that. Once they're painted on, it's more difficult to remove them from paper. But these are maybe destroying the paper, but definitely removable. So that is something to consider when painting with gouache. So now I'm going to be trying Pearl Coral. See if you like this color. Bit of oil. On the top. Once you remove that. Yeah, that's a nice color. I was afraid it would be a little bit too brown, but this is definitely a skin tone, pink in some sort. Coral. Gonna do that one here. Start be messy like that. Then we have gold, which I really want to use. See if the gold is any good. Just knew it would be good, so I didn't try it before I poured it in. Oh, so nice and goldy. We have two of these that are metallics. So this is gonna be difficult. Really difficult. Which ones do I want? Silver, pearl gray, pearl sage, pearl emerald green, the pinks we've added. I do want pearl white, and do I want bronze or silver? Probably, maybe I want this one, or cerulean. Oh my goodness. Oh, can you feel the heartache with this? So, let's try them out, all of them, to see which one we like best. Yes. So beautiful. I like that one. This is emerald green. Oh, so nice. I don't think it will pick up on the camera how the shimmer of these. They are not really that shimmery. Definitely have seen more metallics, but they are not even called metallics. They're called pearl. So that's another kind of more organic shimmer, I think. And then we have pearl apricot. And in this light, it looks very much just like a yellow, mustardy yellow, not too pearly, but I'm sure it does shimmer more if the sun is out or you're moving your page about. Pearl white rose, this one is called. And that's just very light. Can't imagine needing much of that. So this one is called pearl sage green. also very light. Very shimmery. I think I want to try this one as well. How can you have pearl gray? What does that look like? Oh, like metallics of some sort, maybe. Like piping. I like it. They're very nice colors, actually. So let's see, what do we want? I think I'm just gonna be adding some cerulean blue. To that pop cup. Oh, I want to try this one as well. This is going to be a video where I'm all over the place because I cannot help it. This is called Pearl Lavender. And you can definitely see that this one has shimmer in it. And I guess it would be really fun to go in and do like some shimmer details on top of other paints. This one's looked similar and it's called Mauve. I think it's pronounced like that. I don't know. I'm going to try it next to this one to see if it's similar. Not really the same color at all. And I think the regular ones might be covering a little bit more than the pearlescent ones, of course. So for the last, yes, let's add a green. That. Emerald green. I can't decide for the last one, so I'll just wait. This is how it looks so far. With all those yummy, yummy colors. And then you just leave these out to dry. Spritz it with water when you want to use them and go ahead. Clean it up a bit. Oh, can you see how shimmery that is? Anyway. Moving that aside, for my second palette, I'm going to go with normal colors that are not pearls. So these are pearls, and I've tried some of those. Oh, I'm putting those to the side. And let's see. I know I want to try blush pink. And like I said already, peach red. Maybe rose. Maybe wineberry. Let's start with those and see where we go. What color is a wineberry? Interesting. Very dark. Purple, kind of. Like a grape, I guess. Berry for wine. the rose one. Yes, I mean, look at the difference. It looks not as nice on this tube. It looks like a more of a brown, and when you this is, if it was watercolors, like an opera rose, almost. So I really like it. Definitely going to be pouring up some of that, as well as peach red, perhaps. I really wish that the manufacturers were really taking more care to match the tube. It's not really difficult to do swatching like this. It's neon! Yes! It's beautiful! Hello, I'm going to be taking all this out and using it until it's empty. This is my favorite color. And we'll see, the last pink is blush pink. It's a lot more calmer. You can call it calmer, or sweeter maybe, perhaps. I really like it as well. So I'm going to be using, let's see, blush pink. In this. And I mean, this video we will just go through some colors, and if you want me to do a painting with these, I could. So you can just let me know. And I could open up my art journal and do something using the colors. And like I said, I'm not a gouache expert. I'm going to be doing my first reel. I have tried it before, but as far as I can remember, I'm definitely going to experience it for the first time. When I paint with these next. Wineberry, I'm not really interested in keeping that one out. And there are so many beautiful colors. How could you ever choose? Would you like some? Do you like some ballerina pink or some peach? This doesn't look pink to me at all. But now that we know, we can get happy surprises. We're going to try it out. I think this is beautiful as well. And another kind of skin tone that you could use a lot. Should we try it in here? It's going to be just warm colors anyway, so. And how about peach? Oh. Peach. Should we add peach to our palette? I don't know. We're running out of warm colors, except for all the red ones and the orange ones, of course. Maybe we should have a fun orange and one of the reds, which all of them just look horribly not red when you look at this color. So we have crimson, scarlet, and vermilion red. And let's try this one, who looks most red. So, shall I scooch it over a bit? And it's really nice color. I like it a lot. I like that one. This has been open already. This is Santa Claus red. The other one is a little bit more orange when you compare them. Nothing like what it looks like on the tube, if you ask me. Because this looks like brown. And the last one that is not crimson berry is crimson red. And that's another kind of beautiful. Which one of these makes the best pink, you think? Color theory is not even my strongest suit, so if I bring in some titanium. This has been opened, so that happened. It's not opening. Just gonna be trying this white instead, which is just plain white. It does not have an extra name to it. So white looks like white. It mixes with this. You get almost this pink. Yeah, almost exactly this pink. So you can make that color with white and crimson. And if we mix yuck this, you get a with the scarlet red, you get like a, I don't know what to call that color. And this is already dry. So they dry really quickly as well. Oh. Yeah, some kind of lighter orange, of course. So that's that. to my liking is the crimson. It's the winner. Because it makes the nicest pink and it's the nicest like bright happy red. So put these back. And I'm going to pour up some crimson. And try to make sure we can open it again. Like that. And some white gouache. Should I, what do you guys think, add in white then? Or no, I think I'll see. I would like a green one, or should I add an orange one? Oh my goodness, this is so difficult. I mean, all of these looks yummy. And these greens, I like all of them. I wanted to try sage. Did I say that? So let's try sage and then we'll just end the video. Because swatching is an art form that you could perfect and do over and over and over again. Oh, I love this. I have nothing that is similar in my... watercolor palette. So I might add this one to my last bit, or lime green, which is another favorite of mine. Yeah, it's gonna be lime green. I'm just gonna be enjoying the neons. This is almost neon yellow. Definitely going to be adding that into my last little like that. And just to try it out for our last spot on the paper. I'm going to try bubblegum yellow. It's just like a sunshiny yellow that is really nice. It's the perfect color to add to the middle of a flower, I think. So, but we also have some really nice, oh, look at me, I cannot stop. Orange. I like this one so much. Oh my goodness. Why is everything so hard? Oh, no, I'm not complaining. I'm so happy I got to try these after they've been sitting for quite a while. And there's so many more to swatch. I'll do a swatching spread in my next art journal, definitely. And I will keep experimenting with these. Orange, yellow. I think I'll add this to my last because it's beautiful there. And I'll just keep experimenting and I will let you know in a later blog post how I'm liking these colors. I'm just going to be ending the video here with two filled little ceramic palettes that I'm going to be playing around with a lot. A crazy paper of swatching and paint on my hands and a lot more stuff to try out in the future. I hope you enjoyed this video. You give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more in upcoming weeks and months, because I would love that. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.